Jim, don't act so foolish. A prisoner's got to have some kind of a dumb pet, and if a rattlesnake hain't ever been tried, why, there's more glory to be gained in your being the first to ever try it than any other way you could ever think of to save your life.
Why, Mars Tom, I don't want no sich glory. Snake take and bite Jim's chin off, then why is the glory? No, sir, I don't want no such doings.
Blame it, can't you try? I only want you to try. You needn't keep it up if it don't work.
But the trouble all done if the snake bite me while I's trying him. Marse Tom, I's willing to tackle most anything. It ain't unreasonable. But if you and Huck fetches a rattlesnake in here for me to tame, I's going to leave. That's sure.
Well, then let it go. Let it go, if you're so bullheaded about it. We can get some garter snakes, and you can tie some buttons on their tails, and let on their rattlesnakes, and I reckon they'll have to do.
I can stand dem, Mars Tom, but blame if I couldn't get along without him, I can tell you that. I never knowed before 'twas so much bother and trouble to be a prisoner.
Well, it always is when it's done right. You got any rats around here?
No, sir, I ain't seed none.
Well, we'll get you some rats.
Why, Mars Tom, I don't want no rats. Dey's the dad blamedest creeters to disturb body and rustle round over him and bite his feet when he's trying to sleep I ever see. No, sir, give me garter snakes if I's got to have 'em, but don't give me no rats. I ain't got no use for 'em scarcely.
But, Jim, you got to have 'em. They all do. So don't make no more fuss about it. Prisoners ain't ever without rats. There ain't no instance of it. And they train them and pet them and learn them tricks, and they get to be as sociable as flies. But you got to play music to them. You got anything to play music on?
I ain't got nothing but a coarse comb and a piece of paper and a juice harp. But I reckon they wouldn't take no stock in a juice harp.
Yes, they would. They don't care what kind of music 'tis. A juice harp's plenty good enough for a rat. All animals like music. In a prison, they dote on it. Especially painful music. And you can't get no other kind out of a juice harp. It always interests them. They come out to see what's the matter with you. Yes, you're all right. You're fixed very well. You want to set on your bed nights before you go to sleep, and early in the mornings, and play your juice harp. Play The Last Link is Broken. That's the thing that'll scoop a rat quicker than anything else. And when you've played about 2 minutes, you'll see all the rats and the snakes and spiders and things begin to feel worried about you and come. And they'll just fairly swarm over you and have a noble good time.
Yes, they will, I reckon, Mars Tom, but what kind of time is Jim having? Blessed if I can see the pint. But I'll do it if I got to. I reckon I better keep the animals satisfied and not have no trouble in the house.
Tom waited to think it over and see if there wasn't nothing else, and pretty soon he says, "Oh, there's one thing I forgot. Could you raise a flower here, do you reckon?"
"I don't know, but maybe I could, Marse Tom. But it's tolerable dark in here, and I ain't got no use for no flower, nohow, and she'd be a powerful sight of trouble."
"Well, you try it, anyway. Some other prisoners has done it."
"One of them big cat-tail-looking mullein stalks would grow in here, Marse Tom, I reckon, but she wouldn't be worth half the trouble she's cost."
"Don't you believe it. We'll fetch you a little one, and you plant it in the corner over there and raise it. And don't call it mullein. Call it pitiola. That's its right name when it's in a prison. And you want to water it with your tears."
"Why, I got plenty of spring water, Mars Tom."
"You don't want spring water. You want to water it with your tears. It's the way they always do."
"Why, Mars Tom, I can raise one of them mullein stalks twice with the spring water whilst another man's starting one with tears."
"That ain't the idea. You got to do it with tears."
"She'll die on my hands, Mars Tom, she surely will, 'cause I don't scarcely ever cry."
So Tom was stumped, but he studied it over, and then said Jim would have to worry along the best he could with an onion. He promised he would go to the nigger cabins and drop one private in Jim's coffee pot in the morning. Jim said he would just as soon have tobacco in his coffee, and found so much fault with it, and with the work and bother of raising the mullein, and Jew's harp and the rats, and petting and flattering up the snakes and spiders and things on top of all the other work he had to do on pens, and inscriptions, and journals and things, which made it more trouble and worry and responsibility to be a prisoner than anything he ever undertook, that Tom most lost all patience with him, and said he was just loading down with more gaudier chances than a prisoner ever had in the world to make a name for himself, and yet he didn't know enough to appreciate them, and they was just about wasted on him. So Jim, he was sorry, and said he wouldn't behave so no more, and then me and Tom shoved for bed.